Coach House has been Carolina Panthers strength coach for several years now. And he hooked me up with some good tickets. My wife and I went. A couple guys from the gym also went. But Cam Newton is fucking huge. And he's about 6'6", probably a good 260. And just insanely athletic. Really cool game to watch. Raiders came out on top. I was kind of rooting for the Raiders, but don't say anything. Anyway, he's here today. We're going to lift some weights today. We're going to do some deadlifting. I got a little bit of a cold, a little bit of sore throat. So if I sound weird, that's why. I also got my boy, my BFF, Jesse Burdick, with us. Got Fat Dan training us today. And Marcus as well, to kind of bring some energy. Let Coach House kind of feel the energy of Super Training Gym. And after this, we're going to break some bread, eat some food, and have some grub. So enjoy the lifting.
Got recruited as a tackle, moved me to guard, played guard. What do I got to do, buddy?
You want to try out?
Deficit training can also help your grip a little bit, because more time under tension, you hold the bar for a longer period of time. So that exercise is a real bitch. Also, deficit deadlifts are gonna enhance your starting power by making you a little bit stronger from the floor, making you more explosive, having a little bit more range of motion. Your back's in a little bit more flexion at the bottom. And in addition to that, what some people don't understand is that it actually helps your lockout too. Again, it's time under tension, plus you're set up out of position a tiny bit. So instead of being out of position at the top of the lift, you're now out of position for almost the whole lift, depending on your mobility. So give a deficit deadlift a try. It can help increase your deadlift quite a bit.
Yeah, Joe Ken, NFL strength coach, bighousepower.com. Mark inviting me, and Jesse Burda came up with me, and we were just working on my deadlift technique today, just trying to fine tune some things of listening to a bunch of different guys who are way stronger and way more successful in powerlifting than I am. Plus, if I can learn something from a technical side and the kinesthetic awareness that I can feel, it allows me to be a better coach for my athletes. I call my first phase of my training session my pre-activity prep, and it pretty much has two distinct parts: a reset program and then a readiness program. And then my reset is a lot about joint centration, trying to keep my posture and my body in aligned. I'm going to go over this very briefly. The people who taught me this are way more intelligent on these subject matters than I am. Two exercises I use for breathing with the balloon is to help set my rib cage and pull my diaphragm down. And actually, the way I was being taught to deadlift today, that's really gonna come into play now, of trying to keep myself more rigid and keep the arms longer during the pull. Then I'll go into a rolling and rocking program that I got from studying original strength. Tim Anderson out of Fuquay, Varina, North Carolina, which is about an hour and a half from me. So I'll go through a rolling program, which is ultimate to me. It's been the ultimate saver of my body awareness. So I throw that in, and then I'll do some dead bug series. So that's my reset, trying to get the body aligned and prep. Then my readiness work is a combination of different things. One, we're gonna do some type of neck work. I'm a big believer in neck. Everything starts from the head position. and I've got to do a better job on some of my personal lifts of keeping that head position in proper stability and neutral. Then I'll go into some type of root work, or what most people would call core. Most of my stuff is going to be total body and emphasis. Sometimes I'll do get ups, sometimes I'll do windmills. Today I just did a lateral flexion with a kettlebell, so what most people would call side bends. Then I'm gonna do some type of lower body posterior chain type of movement that'll help prep myself for the major lift of the day. Today was deadlift, I used a sumo stance. So today I did a lateral squat with bands. And then I figure out some type of posterior shoulder or overall shoulder movement. And today I did dumbbell halos. But that changes throughout my programming. But generally I'm gonna do something in my readiness, neck, root, some type of lower body movement that's gonna help me prep for the major lower body movement of the day. And then some type of overall shoulder, most with a little bit of emphasis on posterior shoulder development.
2X? 2X, 2X, 2X?
2 or 3 is good.
Yeah, 2. And then a hoodie.
Oh, all right.
So what band?
Yeah, stuff.
Very good.